गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, मैं सर शिल्पा शर्मा फ्रॉम एसी डिपार्टमेंट एंड इन द सीरीज ऑफ डिजिटल सिस्टम डिज़ाइन आई विल कंटिन्यू टुडे विद टीचिंग द प्रोग्रामिंग राइटिंग अ प्रोग्राम ऑन बैरल शिफ्टर्स मल्टीप्लायर्स एंड डिवाइडर्स. सो इन दिस कंटिन्यूशन वी विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम बैरल शिफ्टर. व्हाट इज बैरल शिफ्टर, व्हाई इट इज यूज्ड. A barrel shifter is a digital circuit that can shift a data by a specified number of bits in one clock cycle. So number of multiplexer will be required. For n bit word, it will be nx log n log n. The shifter works by shifting the bits left. In this, we generally use 8-bit shifter in which data bits will be D0 to D7 and encoded selection line will be accordingly. If 8 bits are there, that means 2 raised to power 3. 3 selection line will be required. So S0, S1, S2 will be our selection line. Now, according to input lines, means number of input lines, output lines will be defined. If input lines are 8, then output lines will be 8. So output shifted data bits will be Q0 to Q7 according to input of D0 to D7. Here we will use implementation technology of 0.6 micron process. We will discuss it later around. So a barrel shifter will be comprising a n bit by n bit transistors array arranged into n rows and n columns. See, this is the block diagram of a barrel shifter. This is for 16 input lines. We are defining for 8 input lines also. 16-bit barrel shifter can be made. Here data lines are, which are unidirectional, are 16-bit, and accordingly number of bits to be shifted will be 16-bit. So data out will be 16-bit again. Here a load shift, that means which bit is to be placed, which how many bits it needs to be shifted at a time, we need to write here, no? So load underscore shift input will be required. As it is a digital circuit, many number of multiplexer will be here, so a clock pulse is also required to maintain simultaneously all the working. And reset is the basic requirement of any flip-flop. So this is our block diagram. Now, to write a barrel shifter program, means VSDL code for 6-function barrel shifter, what we require, first, we are inputting 16-bit data. So first we require input lines of DIN, which is 15 down to 0. Now, S, which is used for selection line, for 16-bit input line, we need 4 selection line. If it was 8-bit input line, then selection line must be equals to 3. So it will shift, S will be shifting all the 0 to 15 lines. C is the mode control signal, means is it shifting in left direction or it is in right, shifting in right direction, it will be defined by C input. Now output lines will be according to input lines, that means 15 down to 0 again. These are data bus outputs. Now constant, many constant variables and signals are required. So here we are defining constant L rotate, right rotate, logical rotates and arithmetical rotates. So to define the coding of different shift modes, we need all these constants. So for L rotate, it will be 000, 001, 010 according to left and right rotation of rotation, logical or arithmetic. Now, in the architecture part, what we need to define? We need to define the function of these barrel shifter. First, we define architecture, barrel 16 underscore behavior of barrel 16. Now, we will define the subtype of std underscore vector. Its subtype is what? Data word. Data word will be used in function vro. And if we are using function term, then return must be here. Again, two variables are used here, an and tp, tmpd. These are used to concatenate the all the inputs, means if we are shifting, then temporary value must be concatenated with the shifted value. Then we will obtain the whole value. Now in the starting, we will assign a value n to as a convert underscore integers, and we'll assign a value of input as in a temporary register tmpd. Now we will apply a loop. In which loop we will concatenate all these input and variable outputs. After applying it, we will return the value of finalized value of tmpd. So in this way, we will define and start the architecture part. Now to rotate, we need to define any case, means C will decide now that whether it will rotate right or left, or logically right or logically left. So C will be defining this. So we will apply case on C. So case C is when L rotate, then D output will V roll D in S. In this way, we can define all these cases. You can see that as S will vary here, so accordingly D out will get vary. So in this way, we can define any kind of barrel shifter. In barrel shifter, we can define the rotations in outputs line. See, if we wanted to see the R rotate here, rotation line, whenever R rotate comes, then D out will be assigned a value of V R O R D in S. Here V R O R, what is V R O R? V R O R is a function which is working on data word and unsigned, that means selection lines. According to this function, output will get changed. So in this way, barrel shifter works. So this was the program of any barrel shifter. Now we will switch to the program for multiplier. Now before writing any program, we need to understand what is a multiplier. A multiplier is a circuit that takes two numbers and input and produces their product as an output. So binary multiplier takes binary numbers as input and produces a result in binary itself. For this, we use parallel binary multiplier method for multiplication because it is way more efficient. Moreover, it is similar to method that we use to perform which kind of multiplication? Multiplication of decimal numbers. See, in the multiplication method, as you know, in simple decimal number multiplication method, what we do? We first multiply the LSBs of both the number, then we will shift one by one bit and then multiply the next bits of LSB. Then again. So in this way, we will get the answers. See, P0 will be assigned a value of A0 and AB0. P1 will be assigned a value A1 and B0, XOR A0 and B1. Why? Because we are shifting the input line and multiplying it. Then we will add all these terms. So it will be followed here. See, A0, B0, A1, B1, A2, B2 and so on are here. Then accordingly, we will need a half adder to multiply and add these numbers. So during the writing a program, if we define using data flow modeling, we can directly define the multiplication using this way. In this, 0, P0, P1, P2, P3, all are defined using a formula, which you know why we are using this. Because to multiply the whole value, we need to make a big calculation, but to multiply it, we need this kind of formulas. This is the way using which we can write the program of 2-bit multiplier using data flow modeling. If we wanted to write using behavioral modeling, then what we need to do? We need to define the case and when statement. Case will be A input, and when will be 00011011. If B equals 00, then P will be assigned the value of 00. Else if B equals 01, then P will be 00 again. Else if. So in this way, we can define first statement, case A. Then second case, when 01, then the values will get changed, 10. This is a long method. In this method, we do not need any architecture. We just need to study thoroughly as in a variable case. So in this way, we can write any program of any multiplier. What about if we wanted to write a program for binary divider? What is a binary divider? Binary divider is a device which is able to divide binary numbers. For example, consider the division operation of an 8-bit dividend by a 4-bit divisor, in which a 4-bit quotient is obtained. So it can easily be understood that division operation can be carried out by a series of subtraction and shift operations. See, if you wanted to devise an 8-bit number, divide an 8-bit number using a divisor 1010, what we need to do? We first divide and generate a quotient, then the number will be subtracted and the remaining number again will be subtracted by another number, then again. So in this way, we'll be obtaining a quotient and remainder with the help of divisor and dividend. So it needs to be followed in writing a program. During writing a program, first we need to define what? Dividend and division. These will be input. Then we need to define what? We need to define quotient and remainder. That will be your output line. So, before defining any input line, first we need to get sure about the number of input lines. So, number of input lines, if are 4, then divisor can be 0 to 4. Then accordingly, quotient can vary from 0 to 4. And remainder can vary also. So we are defining the maximum term for dividend and divisor. Now we need to define the architecture. In the architecture part, we are working on two sensitive inputs, dividend and divisor. So in the process list, sensitivity list will be containing dividend and divisor. Now we will define the variable count and temporary. Both will be ranging from 3 to 0. That means 4 lines will be. Now, if dividend is less than divisor, then what will happen? Then it will count it as 0, 0, 0. Else if equals to, then we will count as 0, 0, 0, 1. Else if a greater than, then count will be 0, 0, 0, 1. And temporary value will be subtracted value of dividend minus division. And it will happen while temporary value is greater than 0, then this loop will continue. And the temporary value will be changing after and after until and unless it will confirm the requirement of above set inputs. That means if dividend is greater than divisor, then count will be equals to 0, 0, 0. So how many number of times loop works, then count will be increasing after and after with plus 1, plus. So in this way, the count value will be your quotient value and the remaining temporary value will be your what? Remainder value. So in this way, we can write any program, a program for any kind of binary divider circuit. For now, thank you. In the next or coming videos, we will discuss about the synchronous or asynchronous circuits designing. Thank you.